Hello everyone. Today we are going to start with unit number 3, that is DC to AC converters. And our today's topic is single phase bridge inverter. In today's session, we are going to see introduction about inverters. Then we are going to see single phase full bridge inverter with R load, performance parameters, single phase full bridge inverter with R load, single phase PWM inverter. Myself, Professor Amit Kumar Mishra. I'm having total 10 years of teaching experience and my domain expertise is of 10 years. First of all, what is inverter? An inverter is a circuit which converts DC into AC. It consists of either two or four power devices which are turned on and turned off at desired frequency to convert DC into AC. If power devices are BJT, MOSFET or IGBT, then force commutation circuit is not required. If SCR is the power device, separate force commutation circuit is required. Classification of inverters. First, current source inverter, CSI. Second, voltage source inverter. Let's see current source inverters. Inverter is fed by a current source with a high internal impedance, current limiting inductor, in series with a DC source. Load voltage depends on load impedance, but load current is independent on load. CSI are used at very high power AC drives. Voltage source inverters. Inverter is fed by a DC voltage source of small internal impedance. Load current depends on load impedance, but load voltage is independent on load. Types of VSI. Three-phase inverters, single-phase inverters. Further, single-phase inverters is classified into single-phase, half or full bridge inverters, R or RL load. Second, square wave inverters, and third, PWM inverters. Let's start with single phase full bridge inverter with R load. This is the circuit diagram of single phase full bridge inverter with R load. It consists of four switches, S1, S2, S3, and S4. Basically, these switches are either MOSFET or IGBT, power MOSFET or IGBT. It is for resistive load. So here we are going to get the output and we have connected the DC source. Let's see the operation of this circuit. So it operates in two modes, mode 1 and mode 2. This is the equivalent circuit for mode 1. In mode 1, that is from 0 to T1, S1 and S2. These two switches are going to get closed, whereas S3 and S4 will remain open. So the current will flow from VS to S1 to R to S2 to VS negative, and we are going to get the output. In mode 2, that is from T1 to T2, S3 and S4 will be triggered, so it will be on, and hence we are going to get the output. The current will flow from VS positive to S3 to R to VS4 to VS negative, and we are going to get the output across the load. Performance parameters. So the first performance parameter is RMS output voltage. V0 RMS is equal to VS. Second parameter is RMS output current. So I0 RMS is equal to VS upon R. Third is RMS output power, that is V. Fourth, peak transistor current, IP, is equal to VS upon R. Fifth is peak reverse blocking voltage, VBR, is equal to VS. Sixth, RMS output voltage at fundamental frequency, V01, is equal to 0.9 VS. Seven, RMS value of ninth harmonic component, V0N is equal to 2 into 1.414 into VS upon NI1. Eighth parameter, harmonic factor of nth harmonic. HF n is equal to V naught n upon V naught 1. Ninth parameter, total harmonic distortion THD, that is equal to V RMS square minus V naught 1 square under root of that upon V naught 1. Next performance parameter is distortion factor, that is DFN, which is equal to V naught n upon V naught 1 into n square. And these parameters, the value which we are seeing is for single phase full wave inverter for resistive load. Single phase full bridge inverter with resistive load. These are the performance parameters of that. Next is single phase full bridge inverter with inductive load. So here you can see the circuit diagram consists of four switches, or we can say power MOSFET or IGBT. With that, there are four diodes also, D1, D2, D3 and D4. Load is inductive, so RL load we have connected over here. We are going to get the output across this load. Input is DC source. Let's see the operation of this circuit. So this circuit, inductive load, single phase full bridge inverter with RL load, works in four mode. Mode 1, mode 2, mode 3 and mode 4. Now see how it operates in these four modes. In mode 1, S1 and S2 switch is going to close. That means we are going to trigger S1 and S2 only. So the equivalent circuit will be in this way. The current will flow from VS positive to S1 to RL load to S2 to VS negative. So we are going to get the output across load, and it's an inductive load, so inductor will store the energy. In mode 2, the energy which was stored by inductor in mode 1, now it will dissipate that. And dissipation of energy will be taking place from this load to D3 to D4. So let's see in mode 2. So in mode 2, inductor will dissipate the energy from D3 to VS to D4. Now mode 3. In mode 3, S3 and S4 will be closed. We are going to trigger S3 and S4. Now the current will flow in this way, VS positive to S3 to RL to S4 to VS negative. So we are going to get the output across inductive load. Inductor will store energy. In mode 4, the energy which was stored by inductive load in mode 3, it will dissipate that energy. So the dissipation of energy will take place from D1 to VS to D2. So here you can see that the energy will be dissipated by inductor in mode 4 from D1 to VS to D2 to RL load. Feedback diodes. In the mode 2, diode D3 and D4 return energy from load to supply. Also in the mode, diode D1 and D2 return energy from load to supply. Therefore, these diodes are called as feedback diode. Single phase PWM inverter. This is the circuit diagram of that. The circuit diagram is same as that of what we have seen for single phase full bridge inverter. In this, we have one reference signal. We have one carrier signal. This carrier signal is triangular signal, which has been inserted in rectangular signal. So we can see this part which has been inserted, we are going to get across the output. So this is VDC. You can see this. This is of, here it is of same width, but we can get for different width also. So this is called as PWM inverter. In this lesson, we have learned introduction about inverters. Then we have learned single phase full bridge inverter with R load, performance parameters, single phase full bridge inverter with RL load, and single phase PWM inverter. Thank you.